Hello everyone, my name is Martin Bialas. I'm a member of Atavism team, and in this quick tutorial I will show you why Atavism is so unique and why it is so easy to use it. So what makes Atavism special is basically scalability and performance, but not only that. Also, Atavism was designed with non-coders in mind. And what does it mean? It means that non-coders should be able to use it, easily use it, without coding knowledge. Of course, without coding knowledge, you have to move within Atavism boundaries and possible configurations, but if we thought that if there will be thousands of possible configurations, you will be able to not only build thousands of Atavism game copies, but also you will be able to build your own game, your own configuration. Basically, you will be able to build your own dreamed game. So, because of that, Atavism editor was designed to serve that purpose, and we decided to improve it and to rewrite it from the scratch because we thought that right now it is the main interface in which you are working, in which we are working, and we want to not only improve it, but also we wanted to add new functionalities as well. So first, Atavism editor is fully scalable. So if we will switch to any elements, you will see that let's switch to some longer elements like sword, for example. So you can see that window is fully scalable, and previously this window was with fixed size, so you couldn't scale it. So for the bigger screens, it could be pretty tedious to configure some long list elements, like in this case for this sword, where you have many effects attached to this item. So this is new element. Second element which we wanted to improve is basically all user experience elements, like these buttons, action buttons on the bottom section. So previously you had to, if you had a long list of elements, you had to scroll down at the very bottom of the lists of this element just to click save button. So right now it's in the fixed position, and these buttons are always visible for you. So no matter if you want to change something in the beginning section of this item, it's easy to do it. Another element is this short log that will inform you that which element was updated, but also we added some message elements, like if you will want to delete this item, there will be a message box which will ask you to delete this item or not, and you will be able to delete it. And another element which we added is prevention from delete actions. So basically, if the element is attached to something else, You won't be able to delete it because it caused many issues with server, because server is loading items, elements during the startup. So if this item, for example, was attached to some merchant table, some loot table, you shouldn't be able to delete it, right? So you wanted to basically know that this item is in use and you don't want to delete it. Or if you really want to delete it, you should know that you should head to this particular section. For example, in this case, we can see that this item sort is assigned in quests IDs. So it is on the list in the quest IDs. It is in the inventory of player ID. So this item is already taken by these players. So first, you don't want to delete it. For sure, you don't want to delete it because these players are already having this item. So in many games, many AAA games, AAA companies using such approach that basically they are removing all effects from this item. If they want to make this item obsolete or something like that, they are basically, they don't know if this item is in use. They would have to check it if some players, if any player has this item or not. So basically they are making this effects, they are removing this all effects. So this item is basically will become basically a junk. No, so the player will eventually sell this item. So this is the best approach. And during the design phase, if you will design your game, and you will know that this item, you want to delete this item, and you can wipe your character's data. Then you can do this. Of course, if you will create a new item, for example, let's say material, let's call it some material, and basically let's save it. So if you will assign this item, for example, in some quests, let's head to quest and let's name it, let's say test quest, and let's, for example, give this item as a reward. One item, and let's keep it default. Yeah. So quest was defined. And we will want to remove this this item. It will show us that this item is in use in quests. If we will move to quests, in quest 8, then we can remove this item, set it to known, and let's get back to items. Some, and let's try to delete it again, and as you can see, now we can delete this item. So there is no longer this material available in our configuration. Of course, we can restore it. There is some material. If we will restore it again, you can see that this material is already here because we have filter. right? So this will keep you basically safe to not delete used items, used elements, because it will work for other elements as well, like abilities and effects. So in most places we implemented this this prevention. I think we implemented it anywhere where are constraints. Another thing we which we implemented is because this element will keep you safe from breaking your consistency of data, but in combination, of course, with option to restore restore these deleted elements, you can restore them. For example, most common cases where we all as a developers, which we all as a developers made, is in PlayerCharacter character setup. Basically, if you will delete some PlayerCharacter character setup, for example, let's delete this roach. So we can see we have some data here. We have health configuration. So first we added copy to element here because there are lots of data, so it will speed up your configuration. But also, if you will delete it, you will see that there is no human roach here. And if you will want to create this human roach, it will throw an exception, because in the database this character race and character class in combination creating a key. So this is primary key, so you are not able to create the same entry with the same key in your database, so you couldn't restore this data. Of course, not through the Atavism editor. You could restore it using some third-party tools like phpMyAdmin or MySQL Workbench or any other database management tool. But you couldn't restore this data using Atavism editor directly. So you had to use some third-party tool, which we didn't want to force you to do that. That's why you can restore it. And if you will switch to restore option, you can see that we have human roach here. So basically you were trapped a bit because you couldn't restore it from here. You couldn't recreate this entry again, so you couldn't recreate this human roach here. There would be an error that there is duplicate entry in the database, and basically this entry couldn't be created. So you had to the only way was to restore it. So now it's possible with this option. So you can quickly restore, and you can see that this roach with this all parameters is available. So this consistency checks and this in combination with this restore option basically gives you the ability to not break your consistency, database consistency, and keep your constraints properly. And another element which we implemented is basically not only check consistency and prevent from breaking it, but we also enforced some options here, because for example, for the in the instances, for the instance type of world, you always have to tick that checkbox create and startup. So basically if we know that you always have to tick that checkbox for this instance type world, So why not to enforce it? So you and we couldn't untick it by mistake or something like that. So you are not able to untick it, but you can untick it if you will select dungeon or group dungeon, as you can see, or arena. Basically, it's available for all types of instances except world, because it has to be created on startup. So if you will switch to world, this checkbox will always be ticked. And this is small prevention, but there were many cases where developers by mistake didn't check it, and the instance, the world instance, couldn't be run because player wanted to. It was causing issue because Atavism server didn't start any instance, even the first one where the player is on startup, and when the player tried to enter this world instance, he couldn't. But we moved even further, so the most complex element in Atavism is combat. So here in the abilities, of course you can see that there are many more effects, more coordinated effects available for you. And we redesigned it a bit for this abilities. Basically, if you will select ability type, this ability type will do the check which entities this ability should invoke. So if you will select combat melee ability or magical attack ability, it will do the checks against physical or magical attacks, taking into consideration evasion, physical evasion, magical evasion, physical accuracy and magical accuracy. If you will select effect ability, it will give you one more option here, chance. So between 0 and 1, so you can define if it should trigger, always trigger or not, always be applied or not. Of course, it is taking into consideration 5% of miss. And then we have friendly effect ability, which has 100% success rate. But if we will select friendly effect ability, for example, you will see that here we have target type, and we can select only self, friendly, friend not self, group, and AoE friendly. So basically all friendly entities, and there is no enemy, there is no AoE enemy. While we will, when we switch to combat melee, we can see that we have enemy and AoE enemy only, because we don't want to invoke attack on our friendly entities, right? And again, if we will select enemy, you can see that requires target is always ticked, because for this one enemy we have to select this enemy, because we don't know which enemy is this, so we have to tick this. But if we will select AoE enemy, also we can see that we have new options here, like AoE type, AoE radius, AoE angle, and here we can tick, or we cannot tick it, because we have AoE type player radius. So player radius, AoE enemy, it's around player, so we don't want to check if we have a target or not. But if we will select, so we cannot tick this. If we will select target radius, we know that we have to have target to get the radius around him, right? So we cannot untick this. So we implemented a bunch of checks here to prevent from misconfiguration. On this very early stage, we thought that we will just help us all with this design to prevent from misconfiguration. Another element which is useful, so even if we didn't prevent from everything, like literally everything, you can also use our new Atavism editor logs. So here is a button AO log file, and if we'll click it, you can see that there is also there is this error where we wanted to create our human roach player character template here. So we couldn't create it because there is duplicate entry, as you can see, for this key, and this is unique index, right? So basically there are all updates, deletes, inserts within your database, and this log will rotate, and this log is within your Unity project. So you can always access it, you can check what we change it, when we change it. So you can, if something stopped working for you, you can move through this log, and you will see what you changed basically. To track down the issue, you can also send us this log, so we could help you with your issue if such issue will occur, because it shouldn't basically. Another element which we wanted to implement, or we wanted to improve basically, because it was not working very well, is caching. So in previous Atavism editor version, we had caching, and because it was designed back then when Unity was in version 5 something, Unity changed a lot here in this elements. So over time, this caching stopped working properly. The lists weren't refreshed properly. So we decided to not cache at all. So these lists, as you can see, are generated each time you will click this module. And see how fast it is. We are not waiting to generate these lists. So if we'll click duplicate, you will see that there is no more issue with the name, with the naming convention. So if we'll see, narrow down is the pink star, you will see that the list is properly refreshed. It's because this list is lightweight. It's only ID and the name. And until you will enter it, the data won't be related data, the related lists won't be generated, you know? So this is like super fast. There is no caching, so there is no issue that the data are outdated for some reason, because for some reason when you will enter runtime or exit runtime, Unity will lose references and so on. So we removed many many issues with this caching issue, with this caching, and also on top of that, we implemented multi-languages support. So as you can see here, there is only English version. You will be able to add new entries. Basically, these entries will be added automatically. So if you will switch somewhere where there are no entries for this language, it will be added to this file. Another thing you is that you will be able to add new files for different languages, and we have hope that community will create these files, of course, because you know which languages you want the most to be available within Atavism. We are providing you such ability to create more languages, but we are supporting only English version officially. So if you will create new languages, you can share them or not. It's up to you, of course. You will be able to just basically put this file into the Atavism editor directory, and this file will be loaded automatically with this name, which is the file name. So there are many improvements. We also filled this gap in the help section. So now each element has updated help section. So instead of going into the wiki, you can read all information here. Of course, there are no tutorials at the bottom, but you can also read and watch the videos on the wiki. So what for the Atavism is, you may ask, and the answer is simple. Basically, if you are single developer or really small indie studio, you cannot afford to spend hundreds and thousands of hours just to implement server and client-side logic, because you have so much more things to do. Like you have to design your map, you have to create or just even simply place the models, you have to place foliage, you have to design your points of interest. But even more, you have to design combat, design quests, design even simple behavior like movement, handling movement. You have to design account and character creations. So you have to design items, define them, define currencies, and implement so much more elements like crafting, auction house. Some of them, of course, you don't want to have in your game. It's more like the personal thing. What do you want to build, and what do you want to achieve? But even if you can place thousands of models using some Unity tools like Vegetation Studio will help you to place foliage. You can use ready models for foliage, for housing and so on. You can use natural manufacture models for foliage. You can use Infinity PBR models for mobs. So there are many elements which you can use, which are ready or almost ready, or you can just adjust not to have to reinvent the wheel, you know. But what if you could, instead of spending these thousands of hours for coding, with assumption that you are a programmer and you know how to do this, and instead of doing this coding part, you could focus on actually designing your game, building your game, not on the hard tasks, because single developer won't be able to handle these tasks. You would have to spend really years to build that. But with such tools like Vegetation Studio, like proper models, and with Atavism, which will handle the hard part of the server side, of the client side, there is user interface designed to work with this all Atavism elements. You can actually build your game or prototype your game within a week or two, just to simply check how this will behave, if it will be fun or not. You can add characters, you can add mobs, you can define their skills, abilities, you can define statistics. You can imagine that you want to add some statistic in your game and you don't have a Tavzin. You would have to code it, right? But what if it would be so simple that you would basically could head into the combat stats and you can create new statistic like fire resistance. And if we will save it, it's base stat, and we will head into the damage section, we can create fire damage, right? And resistance stat would be, the choice for this would be obvious, right? This is fire resistance. Save it, and that's it. You can use this fire damage stat for your item, for your combat. So in this case, we will want to create damage effect, and this damage effect will be fire damage. No problem. This is just a few clicks. Nothing. It's nothing you can't do, right? And all within this easy to use interface. There is no coding, and even if you will reach that point where you will have to code something, because as a small indie studio or as a single developer, as a hobbyist which want to, even as a hobbyist, you still want to release your game, even for a small community, but still, I'm sure that you have that dream. And because of this is designed for such small indie studios and hobbyists and solo developers in mind, there are many elements which will handle these hard parts for you. Many times you will have to make compromise, you know, so you will have to build, for example, you will want to build some guild versus guild combat, but it's not included in Atavism, at least not yet. There is guild functionality, right? There is combat, so maybe not guild, there are arenas, you can have PvP. So maybe in combination of that, you will achieve something that it's at least decent for you. And if not, you can always add your code or adjust code which we made for you. You can adjust it using our Aegis server-side code. So this is possible. This Aegis is available for all Atavism license owners. So you can modify it and you can create your own modules. You can create something beyond that we designed. So this is not the limitation. This is the opportunity where you can use Atavism Editor and Atavism goodies, Atavism features, and build on top of that. That's why what is not possible using another tool, using other tools, it's not possible to build an MMORPG game using other tools. It's simple. Why? Because you don't have this graphing interface. You have to code literally everything from scratch. There are some elements, some simple and base elements which you can use, but it's actually impossible to build such game for one person. But with Atavism, and especially with graphic editor and with logic under the hood, you can do this, and you can do this with fun and easily. So this was presentation of new features, new elements of Atavism Editor, which will be available for Atavism 2019.1. And I hope you like it. So see you in the next video tutorial. Bye bye.